confusion.
Ça, ça, qu'on fait dire.
It is used in different parts in the Bible.
And I'll give you a few examples.
Let's go to Exodus 23:22. Everybody, if you are reading, please, if you can, read 1, 2, 3 with me. But if it happens after sunrise, he is guilty of bloodshed. And he must certainly make restitution, but if he has nothing, he must be sold to pay for his debt. Let's go back to verse 2. What is this about this thing? If a thief, okay, 1, 2, 3. If a thief is caught breaking in and is struck so that he dies, the defender is not guilty of bloodshed. You see that? That means mtu amekuja kwako, yeye ni mwizi na ni usiku. Na in the process ya kujidefend, umemugonga na panga, amekufa na ni usiku. You are not guilty. Go to verse 3. This is what it says. But if it happens after sunrise, ni mchana. In other words, sasa unamuona, yeye hana weapon, yeye tu ni mtu na hana nini. If he has, and you kill him. And he has nothing, and he has nothing, and he mchana. You are guilty of what? You are guilty of brandishing. But together with that, a thief must certainly make restitution of whatever he stole. And if he has nothing, what will be done to him? He must be sold to pay whatever he stole. Now hear me.
Sasa sikiza.
Somebody has come.
Mtu amekuja.
Stolen your TV. Your bicycle.
My stand.
And your fridge.
Hata fridge yako imeibiwa.
And after some time you catch him.
Na baada ya muda unamkamata.
By the power of restitution.
Sasa kwa ile uweza wa kufidia.
He doesn't have to bring back the fridge and the bicycle. And the TV.
Ana uwezo wa kuleta ile runinga, baiskeli na fridge ile aliiba.
He is supposed either to pay something that will account for the worth of what he stole.
And I say
either in money, he can pay money to that will account for whatever he stole.
And I say either alipie either kitu inafanana na gharama hizo vitu aliiba ama pesa.
Oh, if he has a cow. And the cow has the worth of the things he stole, he can give the cow.
Na hiyo ng'ombe na maana yake ni ya ile vitu aliiba, anasaidia peane hiyo ng'ombe.
That is called restitution.
Hiyo inaitwa kulipa fidia.
It is different from restoration.
Hiyo ni tofauti na urejesho.
Restoration, it means if he stole a television set, he must pay back a what? A television set.
Urejesha ni kumaanisha kama ni runinga aliiba, lazima arejeshe runinga.
If he stole a bicycle, he must bring back a bicycle.
Na kama aliiba baiskeli, baiskeli alete.
But restitution means he can pay something for the or in price of what he stole.
Lakini sasa kulipia ridhaa, hiyo ni tofauti kwa sababu anaweza lipa kitu ambacho ni tofauti na kile aliibia.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
How many are with me until now? Okay. Let me give you another one.
Wacha niwape ingine.
Go to the same verse 5.
Enda mstari wa 5.
Verse 5 of the same.
Ya hiyo hiyo 22.
Verse 5. Everybody read with me. Now, I think we are in one page.
Tuko pamoja.
Read with me. If a man creates his livestock in a field or a vineyard and let them stray and they graze in another man's field, he must make restitution from the best of his own field
or vineyard.
Or vineyard. So, umeona hiyo?
Umeona.
You are grazing?
Wewe unalisha ng'ombe ama
and then they eat somebody's crops.
Na wanakula mazao ya mtu mwingine.
In the heart and And the spirit of restitution, you are supposed to pay by going to your own field and getting the best of your product and paying what your animals ate.
Sasa katika hiyo roho ya fidia, unastahili uende kwa shamba yako, uchukue mazao yaliyo bora ili uweze kugaramia yale yalikuliwa na ng'ombe.
Go to verse 14, it has another one into, I like this by the way.
Napenda hii.
Verse 14 says,
Mstari wa 14 inasema,
everybody read with me verse 14. If a man borrows an animal from his neighbor and it is injured or dies while the owner is not present, he must make restitution. Umeomba punda ya mtu kwenda kuchota maji
na kubeba kuni.
Alafu hiyo punda imekufa mikononi mwako. Kama yule mwenyewe
hayuko.
Then you are supposed to do what? Make restitution. That means kama huna punda upeleke ng'ombe.
Yes.
Kama huna ng'ombe upeleke mbuzi.
Ndio.
Kama huna mbuzi upeleke pesa. Kama huna nini upeleke mahindi ama maharage.
Maharage.
Ya kusimamia
mumie hiyo punda
ya mwenyewe amekufa akiwa mikononi mwako.
Mwako.
It was the law of protecting property.
Ilikuwa sheria ya kulinda mali.
Amen.
Amen.
Come here with me. Blessed be the holy name of the Lord. I am going somewhere with this very soon.
In a song, mali na hii haya.
Let me give you another one.
Wacha niwape nyingine.
Leviticus 22:14. This one everyone must be very careful with.
Mambo ya Walawi.
22:14. Leviticus 22:14.
14.
It says Leviticus 22:14. Everybody want to read? Anyone eat a sacred offering
by mistake.
Hata hapo napenda. Unapasa tu.
Makosa imetendeka.
Makosa imefanyika umekula. Ile offering ulikuwa utoe umekula.
Umekula.
Fungu la 10 ile ulikuwa upeane umekula.
Umekula. Ni bahati mbaya.
Ni bahati mbaya hata hukujua.
Kupanda hiyo.
Amen. Are you with me? Let's read it again. 1, 2, 3. Restitution to the priest for the offering and add a fifth of the value to it.
Meshika hiyo?
Yo, mekamata. Meshika hiyo?
Yeah.
Yani ulikula sadaka imakosa.
Ipa.
Na hata hukutaka.
Hapana.
Arabu umegundua. Woi mwada ni Jehova. Kai. You're supposed to bring a restitution of the same and add a faith. If you don't have the offering you are supposed to take, maybe it was a cow, maybe it was a goat, maybe it was a chicken. You went, you slaughtered it to your friends. Then you're supposed to take something equivalent, maybe a goat or another.
Kitu inafanana na hiyo
mbuzi ama kitu kama hiyo. Do restitution.
Yani ulipie.
But this time you add a faith of the value of that thing you ate.
Unaongezea 1/5% kwa sababu ya juu ya kile ulikula.
That is important.
Na hiyo ni ya muhimu.
Are you with me wapendwa?
Amen.
Sasa hiyo hamupendi.
Hiyo ni kali.
Hiyo umeondoa.
Hiyo
wengine hata hawakuandika kwa noti zao.
Hiyo
scripture hiyo umepass.
Hiyo
unasema pass. Hiyo maswali unasema na inayo pass.
Pass.
Hiyo ni moja ya wewe.
Hiyo ruka.
Wewe fanya tu pass.
Wewe ruka.
Fanya tu pass. Let me give you another one you might like.
Wacha nikupatie zile
na Job 20:18.
Yohana 20 mstari wa
10. Job.
Ayubu 20.
Job 20:18.
Ayubu 20:18.
I am about to finish by the way. Don't
you karibu kumaliza.
I am about to finish my preaching.
Niko karibu kumaliza.
Job 20:18, the Bible says, everybody with me. 1, 2, 3. That which he labored for shall he restore, and shall not swallow it down. According to this substance shall the restitution be, and he shall not rejoice therein. Go to verse 19. Because he has oppressed and forsaken the poor, because he has violated. abundantly taken away a house which he builded not. One at whose were sana. That's a person who has taken that which does not belong to him. Maybe a person's land or somebody's house. And you have made it your own. Like Ahab taking the vineyard of Naboth. That which he took from a person who labored for it. He must restore and not swallow it down. And according to his substance, he must do a restitution.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Now, everybody hear this. When we read in Acts chapter 3, go back to Acts
3:21.
In less than 19 again, where we began. Acts 3:19. Acts 3:19 again to 21. The Bible says, repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out. When the time of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Verse 20. And he shall send Jesus Christ, which before was preached unto you. Verse number 21. And whom the heaven must receive until the time of restitution
of all things. Which God has spoken.
Now everybody hear this. This is what I heard the Lord speak to my spirit. When Jesus rose from the dead,
wakati Yesu alifuka kwa wafu,
he already conquered the devil by the cross.
Yeye alimshinda shetani kupitia msalaba.
And he redeemed mankind through the blood and water that was highest from his lips.
Na yeye,
the river that flowed is still saving people today.
Na akamkomboa mwanadamu kupitia kwa damu ambayo ilitoka mbafuni mwake ambayo ilikuwa damu na maji.
All the curses were removed.
Na kupitia kwa miiba basi laana sote zikaondolewa.
By his stripes we were healed.
Na kwa mapigo yake tulipona.
He became naked that we may not live naked.
Akawa uchi ili tusije tukaishi bila nguo.
And all he did.
Na yote yale alifanya.
He went to hell.
Akaenda kusimu.
According to the scripture.
Kulingana na maandiko.
And he took the keys of life and death.
Na akachukua ufunguo wa uzima na mauti.
From the devil.
Kutoka kwa shetani.
And now everybody hear this.
Na kila mtu sasa sikiza.
According to the word of God.
Kulingana na neno la Mungu.
Genesis chapter 1 and verse 1.
Kulingana mwanzo moja sura ya kwanza.
In the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. Verse number 2 says, and the earth was without form and void. Normally, we know between Genesis chapter 1 and verse 1 and Genesis chapter 1 and verse 2, there are many years. Because God had created the heavens and the earth. But as we time, the earth became void and empty. Theologically, we know this is where the devil came in and destroyed everything God had made. Are you with me? Now, when you go to when God created man, put him in the garden of Eden. Gave him authority, dominion, to increase, multiply, and rule and subdue. Lost the dominion to the devil. Later on, God realized man was naked. Because he confessed he was naked. God made the first sacrifice and he clothed Adam with a skin. And shortly after that, he was chased from the Garden of Eden. And there were chaos after to have put on the south and eastern side of the garden, so that man may not come in and eat from the tree of life and live forever in sin.
I want to remind you, the children of Israel,
they were in captivity 430
years.
Until God had their cry,
sent
a deliverer. And that night, before they left Egypt, it is recorded in the Bible. Let me give you that. Exodus 12, that is it. Exodus 12, that is it. Everybody, read with me. 1, 2, 3. The Lord made the Egyptians favorable. His force was the people. And they gave them what they asked for. So they plundered the Egyptians. That night, they went to the Egyptians. Told them, give us the best of your clothes. Give us the best of your ornaments. Give us your gold. Give us your silver. And God gave them favor before the Egyptians. Little did the Egyptians know, these people will not be here tomorrow. They were not stealing. They were going through a process called the process of restitution. For 430 years of forced labor and stealing from them and stealing from their children and their parents.
Sasa kwa hiyo miaka 430 wakifanya kazi ngumu, wakiwaibia na kuwaibia hata watoto.
And they were paid the labor of 430 years in one night.
Na walilipwa hiyo kazi ya miaka 40 na miaka 430 kwa usiku moja.
And it is recorded in the Bible. They plundered the Egyptians. In other words, they impoverished Egyptians.
Imenakiriwa ya kwamba waliipora Misri.
They left with everything.
Wakaondoka na kila kitu.
Here you are talking of fake gold. I can assure you this was not fake. This was true gold. They got it through gold and through silver. And all the wealth of the Egyptians. In one night. In a process called the process of what? Restitution.
Katika jia na binu ambayo inajulikana kama jia ya kulipa fidia.
How many are with me and you now? Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Now everybody here.
Sasa kila mtu sikiza.
I heard the Lord put in my spirit.
Nikasikia Bwana akiweka katika roho yangu.
It doesn't matter what the devil has stolen from you and from your family and from your life and from your destiny. Jesus, by the process of restitution, in the 40 days he was here, he started a program of restitution in order not only to save us.
Ya kwamba haijarisi kile ambacho shetani ameibia katika maisha yako, lakini Yesu katika siku 40 alizokuwa hapa duniani alianza utaratibu na mpangilio wa kitu inaitwa kule kulipia fidia, na sio tu kwa
kutuokoa, but also to ensure that whatever God had intended you to become, you will not only be saved but also become what God had intended you to become in this life and the life to come.
Lakini pia aweze kufanya sio tu kwamba uweze kuokoka, lakini uweze kufanyika kile Mungu alikusudia ufanyike, si tu kwa maisha haya, hata kwa maisha yanayokuja.
I can see people here today who are believing on
God. Watu hapa leo,
the files were open here on earth and in heaven.
Sasa hizo files zilifunguliwa hapa duniani na mbinguni.
Trying to compare who you are today and what you are supposed to become. Who you are today and what you are supposed to become. Who you are today and what you are supposed to become. Who you are today. What the devil had been raising you to be and what you are supposed to be originally.
Yani kile shetani ya amekudunisha umekuwa na kile unastahili kuwa.
And Jesus connected that which you were supposed to become and that which you are today, and a process of restitution had begun. Had begun. Had begun.
Mpangilio wa kulibeba
kitabu.
Had begun.
And I am here to tell somebody today.
Na niko hapa niambie mtu hapa leo.
By the spirit of restitution.
Kwa hiyo roho ya fidia.
It doesn't matter where you think you are today. Where you are today does not matter. Jesus has already put things in place in order to make you who you are created to become.
Sasa ingerisi uko wapi leo, lakini Yesu ameanza utaratibu ili akurejeshe na akuweke vile unastahili uwe.
And that process is going on even now as I'm speaking to you.
Na hiyo mpangilio inaendelea hata saa hii ninapokuzungumzia.
I don't care whether you went to school or not. It doesn't care whether you are married or not. It doesn't care how you got married or how you did not. It doesn't matter who you are today. What matters is that the file of who you are required, created to become is already found. That file that was lost is already found.
Imepatikana.
I tell somebody today, hey, found.
Nasema kwa mtu leo imepatikana.
How many are hearing my voice?
Wapi wanasikia sauti yangu?
How many are hearing my voice?
Wapi wanasikia sauti yangu?
For the day,
siku 40
of Jesus here on earth.
Yesu hapa duniani.
Was to take back the files.
Ilikuwa ni kulete hizo faili.
And make sure that everybody is connected to the destiny which originally they were created to be. It doesn't matter how far they have fallen. It doesn't matter how what they are going on through. If the truth is this, by the spirit of restitution, the heavens will work day and night.
Yes.
So shall be employed day and night. The angels will never sleep until they make sure that every file that has been put on the table, it is put in its original state. And everybody who is in Christ has become what they were created to be, not about where they are today.
Yes. Yani kuna maraika wata wailala baka wakikishi ya kwamba failo ambayo imeekelewa pale, ya kwamba mtu yoyote ambaye ni Mkristo amefanyika kile amekusudiwa kuwa, sio kile alivyo sahi.
Even the devil never killed you yesterday.
Hey.
He will not kill you today.
Come
on, he cannot succeed in killing you because he has already done it.
Yes.
He has already done it.
Come on, Baba. Kama shetani akukua jana, hawezi kukua leo, amechelewa.
And as long as you are alive,
wewe uko hai,
so that you may be restituted to become what God intended you to become. Let me break it down.
Watch
me
let the chini.
To the level you can understand.
Katika kiwango ambacho unaisaelewa.
66.
Kaa chini.
Jesus,
Yesu,
he was God.
Yeye alikuwa Mungu.
When he was in heaven.
Wakati alikuwa mbinguni.
The Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
Make. Jesus,
Yesu,
he left his throne in heaven.
Akaacha enzi yake mbinguni.
Came here on.
Akashuka hapa duniani.
Born as a man.
Kasaliwa kama mwanadamu.
Born in a manger.
Kasaliwa kwa
Now, I want you to know,
nataka ujue,
Jesus did not become God by being born in a manger.
Yesu hakufanyika Mungu kwa kusaliwa kwa holy.
He was already
yali halikuwa Mungu.
Can I tell you something?
Niwaambie kitu.
Even if Jesus was born on a tree,
hata kama Yesu angesaliwa juu ya mti,
even if he was born in a cave,
hata kama angesaliwa kwa pango,
where he was born could not matter anything.
Ibali alizaliwa ingejalisa hata
hiko. Because already he was who?
Kwa sababu tayari alikuwa nani?
Already he was who?
Alikuwa
he was God.
Alikuwa Mungu.
So being born in a manger was immaterial.
Kwa hivyo kule kusaliwa kwa holy haimaanishi chochote.
He was already
God. Yeah, yani alikuwa Mungu.
When he appeared before Pilate,
wakati alitokea mbele ya Pilato,
he was already
God. Yeah, yani alikuwa Mungu.
he went to carry the cross. He was already God. When he came to be baptized by John, he was already God. Nothing that was made of him or what he went through that made him anything or less of who he was.
Hakuna kitu ambacho alifanywa ama alipitia ambacho kilimfanya chini ama kutokuwa kile alikuwa.
Jesus not became God because he was born by Mary. He could as well have been born by wa rogo or wa odiam adiapo ama akech. He could still be God.
Angebaki Mungu.
Because it was not about being born by Mary.
Maana haikuwa kuhusu kuzaliwa na Mariamu.
He could still have been born by an Indian.
Angezaliwa na Muhindi.
I'm the mother of Jesus.
Yeah.
Jesus was born in my family.
Mama Muchina.
Aminga.
Yeah.
Abdi. Abutubutu.
Yeah.
He would still be God. He could not become God because he was born in
China.
And I heard the Lord say, it doesn't matter what you are going through now. It doesn't matter what you have become. It doesn't matter the degrees you got or you did not. It doesn't matter the family you got married to or not. It doesn't matter the children you got or not. It doesn't matter the job you got or not. It doesn't matter what somebody stole from you or from your family. You are file that describes you, who you are before you are born, has been found. Shake somebody up. Shake somebody up. Shake somebody up. From this moment as you hear me,
yes.
May the revelation of the word I'm bringing to you bring something to be burned in your spirit,
yes.
That shall change your life
in the name of the Lord Jesus. Yes.
If this one is yours, receive it now in your spirit, in the name of the Lord Jesus. May God connect you. May God make you who you are created to be. No more oppression of the devil.
Hakuna kufinyiriwa tena na shetani.
No more sleepless nights.
Hakuna kukosa usingizi.
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Katika jina la Bwana Yesu.
I speak restitution.
Hallelujah. Come on, everybody, lift your hands as we lift our voices. Come on, say, my God is awesome. Come on, say, he can move mountains. Keep me in the valley. Come on, say it. Happy from the rain.
Happy from the rain.
That's it.